Hello bros, I'm Test Effect Zero, Profile Production, and the next part, Minecraft Lord of the Rings mod. So, yeah, I'm not 100% on what that changed since last time doing AFKing. I did AFK in the piglin farm for a while. And I got a good amount of pumpkins, a good amount of melons, and of course, as I said during the last episode, I have actually fished, so now it's finally got the 8 Nautilus shells we needed. Took a hell of a long time. Too long for my preferences, at least. Alright, so let's go and see how much it actually was that I got from the piglin AFK, but I also want to see. I got 5 shoot. Is that enough for a helmet then? Yeah, turtle shell helmet. That's what all we need to shoot for, right? That's way too many. There's too many of these. So we need to kill them. But easier said than done, I suppose. How about that? Yeah, we can kill a few more. Let's see, 2, 2, 2. Yeah. There is 6 left now, I think. A little hard to count them when they're swimming around that much, but I do believe there are 6. We're gonna put the seagrass there because that's where technically the best place for it to work. So the turtle helmet gives a good amount of water breathing, right? Alright, proof that I pretty much AFK'd. I think that is my XP level. 210. That's a lot. Oh, what the hell are all these doing here? God, why are there so many of them? Oh. Think I need to clear them out. Oh crap. Too many of them. How much did I get? Oh, 2 stacks of gold blocks. That's actually pretty good. That's also a good amount of golden nuggets. Alright, let's turn these into gold. I cleared out this pretty much as I felt like was necessary. So now I just wait for them to finish this up. This is multi. Yeah. Liquid blazing blood. I'm just gonna wait for them to finish all of this. Splash potion of fire resistance, I guess. It is the easiest way to farm a lot of this stuff. I mean, I know we went farming for Blackstone and, well, it took a long time to farm it, and I think this is the way we're gonna get Blackstone henceforth. I think you should be able to get a netherite scrap. No, ancient debris. You should be able to get one piece of ancient debris, but it's like 0.1% chance. So you like have to give them like 1,000 to actually have a chance of even getting one piece. So you could do it, but it's technically would take forever. Considering how much golden blocks I actually have, we could technically try to make this automated, but it would be pretty annoying considering of all our things. It would be annoying for we would have to try to construct this in a way that the gold gold ingots never end up in the hoppers. I mean, I don't know how those gold ingots even ended up there. It would also be nice if we could find a non-stackable resource, so, and then make like a hopper chest out of that, so we could actually get them out. So we don't have to get the non-stackable resources in the same box, because it does fill up pretty quick. Before we can pick up the things that are thrown out, we do have to wait for them to pick up all the gold. We can pick up the potions and bring them with us outside. Good amount of resources. I also brought out the soul speed boots and put them in the chest in the overworld. Oops. He still have gold. How much, hopefully slowly is he actually picking it up? Could get soul speed boots, and but this only would work on the lowest floor, I suppose. I mean, you could get soul speed boots and put the soul sand on your lowest floor, and then carpet over it. Okay, the spectral arrow seems to be filling up. I have a lot of spectral arrows. Alright, let's head to the world with all of this. So if I have spectral arrows on me, the spectral arrows actually do get used. Interesting. A chest full of spectral arrows. What more could you ask for? So, technically, you should always create a gold farm. And... okay, this is a lot of actual potions. Right, let's get all the fire res out. I mean, there's only fire res here. So I need a chest for only fire res. Put the turtle helmet in there for a little bit. Alright. No, not there. Where should I put this then? I mean, I suppose I can remove this trapdoor and then put it like this. Else goes in with this. Let's put in the splash potions first and see how much that fills up. Why does it game always persist on putting these things at the wrong place? I mean, that side is not where you put tools you actually use often. How good is actually the turtle helmet when it comes to water breathing? Is this just like normal water breathing? Yeah, it just gives you an extra 10 seconds. I suppose if you enchant it, that's a different story. Does the turtle helmet actually have durability? Because if it actually does have durability, we should still harvest shoot a bit. So let's get the Nautilus shell and one Heart of the Sea. Conduit. And as far as I know, you also need these. So let's get some normal prismarine blocks. We have a lot of them. It is technically nighttime and we should technically sleep because of the phantoms. I have thought a lot about my mega base, but I can't for the life of me figure out exactly how I want to do it. So I think I'm actually gonna start off with some other things I want to do. Alright, let's find a good place somewhere underwater where to put the conduit. I want it to be deep down, at least. We should go over here. This is deep over here. Let's see, is this... Yeah, this is like the deepest place there is close to me, I think. I can check on the other side of the bridge, but I don't think there is any place as deep. This actually is a little bit nicer area. But actually, right over here. I think I'm gonna put it here. So let's go up and get some air first. Alright, so let's go to there. Okay. Yeah, so it's aware. This is actually the first time I'll ever building a conduit base, so. Damn it. Right, let's go up and get some air because I'm gonna drown before I get the conduit done. Let's get our air bubbles up, because I will always look at it if it's not full. Okay, that actually looks very nice. So what effects do I have? Only conduit power, and it charges every 2 seconds. That's nice. Oh god. The question is, how far does the conduit power last? Okay, let's see here. The conduit power is at the block. Wait. 49. So let's go 10 blocks here. 59. Still conduit power. 69 conduit power. 79 conduit power. 89 conduit power. 99 conduit power. 39 conduit power. Okay, so the reach of it is pretty good, at least. Being too close to it gives it this sound, though. And of course it doesn't keep drowns away. Oh wait, it does actually hurt them. That's nice to know. Okay, so it does, it kind of reaches only to like over here, I guess. Well, actually, you can see it. If I just go closer to it and we see when it kicks in again. Okay, here. And the conduit is all the way over there, so it is a pretty good reach. And there's a Trident guy coming for me. I can't even see him, so I'm just gonna get leave. I do actually have some conduit power down here, but it's gonna wear off in a moment, I think. Yeah. Conduit power at least gives me able to see underwater, which is pretty nice. I did only tell it it gave you infinite water breathing. Found that in and wasn't correct. Splash potion of weakness. Yeah. There's a good bit of iron golems around. Yeah, that's way too many of them. Let's go and grab some lava. What are you doing over here? You're not supposed to be over here. It's private property! Where do I... Don't I have lava somewhere? I'm pretty sure I do. Yeah, here it is. Let's execute most of those villagers because there are too many of them there. That ain't nice. How many ore is in there? Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, there's a lot of them in there. How do I get that bunch out? I mean. look around a little. So I want to start making the village more, well, let's say useful. So I'm planning to make more places of work. That's probably the best option. But of course I need to make the roads, so I'm gonna make the road around the farm first, and then I'm gonna make the workstations more, because the village is the kind of the thing I feel we could work on now. I mean, it's been a long time since we actually worked on the village per se, so I think we're gonna do that. So that means Blackstone first of all. And we need smooth Blackstone, because that's the kind of the Blackstone I find is the best for the roads. I'm gonna make the light poles probably last. think we're gonna make have mushrooms around. Think we're gonna make it so it's leveled, and all the mushrooms we have around right now are elevated. So I think I'm gonna remove all of them. It's a little funny that I actually only put golden carrots on all these plates. I actually just thought of it, but we do actually have something fun. I mean, we're gonna make this a fully functioning village. It could very well work on its entirely own. But we do also have the one place in the town that is not gonna be used, and it's pretty much the whole back side here. So I think I'm gonna make this like a dark alley or something like that. Just black market and such. But also I thought of it, we don't like the fact that the villagers does turn into witches and such. So I thought, what kind of defense could I make up for that? I mean, the obvious one is kind of making a roof above the roof, but do we actually want that? I mean, I could easily just put a little high up here, like 3 or 4, I think would be enough. And just build a floating roof. I mean, nothing will spawn up here, so we could technically make it like that, or we could build an actual, try to build an actual roof for it. I mean, there are many options. Ah, you actually spread out a little now. Time for execution! There's just 3 in the doorway now. That's a... fine. So... first thing I believe I want to make is an actual smithery, which means I do need some stuff. I mean, it makes sense that the smithery is made of stone bricks. What else do I have here? We can probably use some chiseled stone and some stone brick stairs. Even imagine some dry stone thing that would be worth functioning. Let's see, what else kind of stuff do I have laying around? Well, we need an anvil for it. I think that's fitting. I do plan to be polished and assigned. So this is a workplace, not a house. Houses, I'm gonna make them a little lighter, not right now. So to make the dark alley, we should start by marking out where the dark alley should technically start. Okay, I should not jump in the farms. Okay, this is kind of where the dark alley should start. So we cannot put anything in front behind this. But I think the take down that and this. This, do I think, is a good size for a smithery. Oh, blacksmith. It depends how you, what you want to call it. We need some more polished andesite and some other things. Haha! A very well cooked potato. A very well cooked potato is called coal. I mean, to cook anything long enough and it turns into coal. Some of the workstations I want. I want a smithing table, but I also want a grindstone, and you need a stone slab for that. Stone. Alright. The smoker is not in it, but a blast furnace actually would be useful. Because a blast furnace does fit in with the blacksmith living. Slime steel in it. Yeah. Just wonder what it was. How do you make a blast furnace? Because I don't actually know how. Actually, we can just search for it. Glass, iron and smoked stone. stone. Do I need a normal furnace for it also? Yeah. Alright. Let's put away the prismarine blocks. Forgot what it was called. Right. Hey, did I? No, I did not get it. So I need a more polished andesite. Can also deposit the dirt because I'm not gonna need that. Does look fine right now, but it's not even close to the idea I have in plan. Also need, let's see, one hay bale, and I need some logs for now. I don't completely know how to make it. Let's see if I got it right. No, I do not. Do I need more sticks by any chance? Yeah, there. Campfire. And that's kind of how I plan to make first, but I need some spruce fences, and I do need spruce slabs, but that's not enough slabs. I need more. But we can put away some. Actually, I think they might actually have it stone, actually. Yeah, it does make more sense, actually, to have it of stone. I have two of them. Yeah, that looks about kind of how I thought I liked it. It doesn't look half bad, actually. I do guess the villagers need more houses, and before I make other workstation, I do believe I want to do that. Okay, how much did I got a lot of leather? I want to get bookshelves, but I think I'm gonna buy them. They're gonna keep annoying me forever. And ever. And ever. And ever. I can't keep saying and ever for ever because it's gonna do that. I don't like to leave things half finished, but as soon as I finish it, I nearly feel lose the feeling to keep going. As long as it's not still things to do. Like in Dying Light 2, I finished the main story and now I have a lot of things to do at the side of. Where should I put the first next house? I mean, I think these spots will be great for either storehouses for food or more small houses. I've not decided yet. These places, well, I don't know really what I'm gonna do with them. But at least the corner spaces are good, and the one next to the road, so I'm not really sure. I think I'm gonna put the next house here. Let's put it like here. Yeah. Let's just get it marked out before we make it look nicer. What are you doing? That too low. Yeah, it feels too low. Okay, I need more spruce, and the test tree is meant to be cut down anyway, so let's cut down the test tree. They're inspecting the housing I'm building. to grab lanterns also. Oh, God. My leg. It feels. My leg. Always when I'm sitting comfortably, I'm sitting on top of one of my legs. Well, there's a standstill too. You actually sell a lot of the shells. Couldn't you have come like much earlier? 1 hour should kill it. No, it did not. Huh? Let's see. Did any farmland get destroyed? No. No farmland got destroyed. That's good. I need a balcony. Proper lanterns. Well, let's just take a stack of sticks. Let's put away most of the wood. Wait, what wood do I have yet? No. So let's put the saplings in here because they are overnumbered saplings. Dirt on me. guess it'd be nice if I could make it so the furnace always was turned on, but I would need hoppers to make that be turned on for a long amount of time. And yeah, I'm not gonna do that. But it would be like funny if you could, like, if the Minecraft lake made an item that can technically get cooked always, but like never ever stops being cooked, so the furnace is always like turned on. Would be fun if warning traders always spawns at the maximum distance they can spawn and then move closer to the area you're in. I would never see the actual wandering trader a single time if that was the case. Not the best, but least functional. I haven't made a door. And I also need windows. Damn poisonous potatoes everywhere! I could actually remove this corner piece here. Just try to make it look a little bit nicer. A little more, well, uneven is the proper word. Yeah, I think that's a little better. A fine house, I think. Two beds for two people and one other bed. This bed is specifically for a child, but yeah. You don't really get the choices on who to use the beds. You just have to guess for that, and even if a child gets to use that bed, well, one thing is for sure, it's not always going to be a child because they're going to grow up eventually. There's three people that works at this place. This should not cause any problems. Yeah, didn't. Good. Red mushroom. Isn't the red mushrooms in English called fly amanita? I'm not really sure about that though. Did put the soul speed boots in here. Yeah, soul speed 3 and soul speed 3. That sounded like lava. Should not be any lava nearby me. Do I need nuggets for what I'm planning to do? Maybe I just need a few nuggets. Cobalt are they? 11 blocks. Let's turn that on and I'd be right back. plate boots, plate leggings, plate chest plate, and plate helmet. I have no idea what I'm supposed to do with it. Chainmail boots, chainmail helmet. Smelt the materials in you for dust founder and tinker sketch tree. Can be created from casting ender slams on a skeleton skull in a basin. What? What are you talking about? Place one of these skulls in a casting basin and adding ender slime can enhance the ability as a helmet. Oh. Interesting. Very interesting, actually. Slime lighter. Tired of walking, try flying with these futuristic wings. To create these futuristic wings, you simply need to pour ender slime on an elytra. This slime lighter can later be repaired using phantom. Well, probably mean phantom brains. Hydro ability, no armor defense slots, 5 upgrade slots, 1 ability slots. I mean, things is getting interesting when you check this out. If you can hit the Ender Dragon with the force of an explosion, it may drop one of its scales. I was told the easiest way to do this is breaking an end crystal while it's hit is healing the dragon. Though TNT can also be effective. So far I have been unsuccessful in obtaining a scale, though once I do, I have heard that Tool has found a way to use them to make tools more powerful. Man, if I can make a sword with a dragon scale, that would mean we can make some truly interesting things. These blood red islands are occasionally found in the lava oceans of the Nether. They tend to have a higher concentration of magma cubes than the rest of the Nether. It also includes an odd variant of fungus that seems to be a source of ichor. I have no idea. Clay Island. Yeah, that's an unusual one. If you have discovered that it is possible to remove modifiers from tools using a wet sponge, removing the modifier gives me back the space for new modifiers, and some of the item can be salvaged as well, based on where I scrub the tool and how many sponges are used. Different modifiers are removed. Does that actually mean remove the sponge, or is it just like removing the wet sponge and give you back a normal sponge? Yeah, the piggyback thing. Remember that. Quartz is far lighter than flint and far sharper. Sugarcane is carved from quartz, it has made finding way causing monsters much more damage.
though less knockback. Yeah. The two variations of copper, considering I have the Lord of the Rings mod, it doesn't. They both are actually cooperating in such the as then both knowing it's copper, but that's just about it. Traveler's gear. Dog is fit for a king, or lemmings, or a king lemmings. Okay. A good pair of goggles provide for safe adventure, easy sight, and the makings of a king. Yeah, I have no idea what the hell you mean by that. Don't forget, chest plate important to protect you, important chest organs, and look mighty fine while doing so. I mean, what can I upgrade them with? Modifiers are extra enchantments that can be applied to tool similar to enchantments. The section below describes the type of modifier traits or abilities. I mean, the books are helping you, but they're not helping me right now. Blazing bone? What? Harness the full power of the Nether Fortress. Bone and blaze. It is interesting, and getting a couple of blazing bones actually do sounds like fun. What? You are non-violent, huh? Well, I have seen some of those piglins carrying lanterns filled with the blazing liquid. Think they use it for lighting. They might part with it for a price. Yeah. They have given me a good number of them. Armies crafted in crafting station instead of the tinkering station on anvil. The mighty plate armor boots are high defense but less modifiability. Who needs extra features when you can be protected? Hard hats for hard heads. A good solid helmet to protect your brain. Nothing can hurt the head of yours. One ability slot, four defense slots, and one upgrade slot. High armor, high durability. High durability, high armor. And let's see, high armor with the chain buttons to provide flexibility. Can't get much cooler and defensive as this. Doesn't this also provide information about upgrades? Modifiers? Upgrades? No, it doesn't really. Well, for defense. Defense modifiers. Defense are a type of modifier exclusive to armor boosting protection against particular treat, such as fire or knockback. They provide another way to customize armor as much as most armor types lack material traits. Like many other modifier types, defense modifiers require defense slots for to be applied. Typically, armor with a large number of defense slots start with fewer upgrade slots, meaning functionality is sacrificed for protection. Mighty Smelting also has a full list of defense modifiers available on tools, along with the encyclopedia of tinkering. here's Punis melting, but how do you get the might is melting? I mean, how do you get that book? I want to know how to get that book, but I have no idea how. Actually, give me a moment. Minecraft Tinker's Construct Mighty Smelting Book. There should be some way to find out. I don't think this will work, but if you take this and put this in a crafting table, yeah. Okay, so the way online they say as how you actually get the mighty smelting book is you need materials and you volume 2. But yeah. How are you supposed to do it in this version then? Could possibly work. Okay, there's one other way that I find online that might work. I don't think so, but we can try it. I'll just take all the books and try. I put that there. That does nothing. That does nothing. That does nothing. That does nothing. I think the book is actually not acquirable. I mean, let's take a look. Tinker's World, Tinker's Gadgets, Tinker's General Items, the book should be here. Let's put that there, and just, let's see if that kind of gave us an idea how to get Mighty Smelting Book. If I don't, I have no idea, really, otherwise. Yeah, that book does not exist, I believe. Yeah, you can't get, I don't think you can get your hands on that book, so. Well, considering how long I actually tried to get that book, well, I'm gonna get two of them because I need two of them. Because I'm gonna make the encyclopedia of tinkering after all. So I mean, considering how high I I tried to get this book, and it I haven't found any way of actually doing that. My dismantling, hope you are ready, fellow Tinker. So you survived this far, fellow Tinker, and perhaps you are smarter than I believe. Well, then let's take that puny melter and those puny metals and make them even stronger. Yeah. Enter the melting. Notable entities: silverfish, seared stone, villagers and pillagers, emerald, that's interesting, skeletons, milk, perhaps there are even more to discover. There are. So if I melt down villagers, I can get emeralds, but that's kind of useless considering I can trade so much. Let's see about armor. Wait. Dual wielding. Huh. Increase underwater mining speed, single level requires ability slot 1. Yeah. So if I add a lot of slime blood, I can actually make the bounce thing still. Double jump? Yeah, I don't need double jump, but bounce would be good when fighting the end dragon. Flame walk, wake, leaves fires where you walk, area boosted by expand, maximum level. Frost walker, looting, path maker. Plowing, pockets, shield strap, grants an extra offhand slot. Huh, that's actually don't seem that bad. Question is, where do I get slime bind? I mean, I think I can get the sliming ingots without any big problem actually. Let's just throw these slime balls in there and we'll see what happens. Okay, let's just do this. Sky slime, 3 blocks. How do you get sliming at the end? Unarmed attack. Increase damage on the water and increase swim speed. Makes sense. Fans will not attack you. Yeah, of course. revitalize. New levels, what a throwback. Can apply levels incrementally. Maximum 2 levels on the helmet or boots, maximum 3. It doesn't say what it does. Wait. That was the last page. Think you can read dragon tongue nonsense. What do they teach these days? That says dragon that fly are deadly and protected. Increase protection and attack damage from airborne. Every first book, everything it needs. How do you make it then? It doesn't show the crafting recipe, really. Oh, that one. There we go. Aha! Everything. Now we have a slime slime island right over there. Does that have slime mines? I don't think it does, but let's go and check. Yeah, there's no slime vines there. But they are actually hanging slime vines off the Sky Island. And how do you get up to Slime Island? There's only really one way I really think is validated to get up there. To get up there, I do technically need bone meal. Let's get an entire stack. And then I need some twisted vines. Let's grab some dirt because I do actually need some dirt to get up to the water level so I can actually get up there. I do also need 2 iron ingots to make some shears. Now let's sleep. pretty good at aiming. Slime mines. What is most effective here? It's a shovel, right?
Yeah.
That's too effective, actually. Normal slime balls. It's actually an interesting view from up here. Come on! It's hard from this height to actually hit them precisely. Are there any unusual things here? Doesn't seem like it. Ah! Yeah, that's a disc kind of stuff. Yeah! Try to move towards them and it bounces you back. Ow. Three, four, five, six. Oh, there's a bin in this. This way. Let's put the bone meal back in the box. Well, I do believe that is it for right now. Sadly, that was all I have for this time. So, hit like and subscribe. See you next time. Bye bye.